It's your brother, Jason. Yeah, it's been a while. I've been busy. Look, I don't really have time for small talk right now. I need a favor. I'm moving out and I need some help. Thought maybe my dear brother could spare a few hours. Life happens, all right? Look, I don't need to explain myself to you. Can you help or not? Great. I'll meet you outside in 5 minutes.
I've been fine. Nothing special has been going on, really. Just the same old routine, I guess. Probably just a church bell or something. Anyway, are you still looking for a new job? Yeah, sure, I guess.
Hello, and welcome to... My name's Steve, and I will be your personal AI assistant for today. Before we begin, an identification scan will be needed to identify the cause of your death. Please stand still. The cause of your death is blank in my database, which means you are still alive. Can since I can't assign you to an aftergrave without a valid death permit, I will release you to freely roam the... until the ones who brought you here decide to send you back. But before you go, I'm required to supply you with the... This is used to relive old memories by pairing it with a memory orb in order to counteract insanity. I would advise you to stick to your own memory orbs. Unless you like peeking into other people's memories. Anyways, you will now be transferred to... Ta-ta-ta!
Hello, and welcome aboard on the Visitor Glide. You are currently being transported to the aftergrave of your inviter. You will arrive shortly. A welcome gift has been sent from your inviter. The teleportation of your gift will commence in approximately 3 seconds.
Incident that has shocked the community. A house fire has resulted in the loss of 3 lives as it appears to be a sacrificial ritual orchestrated by a cult. The victims have been identified as 38-year-old Africana and her 12-year-old son. Tragically, the father also lost his life in the hospital a few days later from lung damage in a heroic attempt to rescue his family upon discovery.
Thank you. Laundromat again? Our dryer's too small for this guest room load.
Hey babe, quick question. Did you happen to change the computer password?
Oh yeah, I did, actually. I meant to tell you, but it completely slipped my mind.
No worries. It happens to the best of us. Why the change, though?
Well, our little tech whiz of a son has been spending more time on the computer than on his schoolwork lately. So I thought a little password change might redirect his attention.
Ah, sneaky move. So where's the new hiding spot for the password this time?
Behind the dryer in the utility room. Figured it would be a safe bet.
Got it. Thanks for keeping things in check, darling.
Anything for our little troublemaker, right?
Exactly.
Thank you. I think he's here now.
Are you sure it's him?
Yes. I saw the symbol on his arm. It's him.
Thank you. You should have seen the look on your face, you absolute pussy. Anyways, I have been sent over to inform you that an individual from another afterlife has requested a visit to call with your name on it. Isn't that exciting? I have spawned a phone for you to use a bit far into the rooms. Future policy! We only allow a short amount of phone time between visitors and the dead. So, make it quick. Ta-ta!
I know you. I'm not allowed to speak to the visitor phone for too long, so listen very closely. You need to keep moving forward. Eventually, you will find the aftergrave exit. Pass through it, and you will be safe from them. From there, I've arranged the visitor glide to come pick you up and take you to my location. You have to talk. Good luck.
Thank you. Thank you. Looks like there actually is an afterlife. It maybe just isn't what I expected it to be. Me and Chase have been assigned to this thing called an afterlife. From what I've understood, it's an extension of the place you were at when you died. We both got killed in our home, so that explains the enormous house, at least. I hope William is going to be okay without me and Chase. I miss him so much. The burn scars still haven't gone away. I don't recognize my little boy's beautiful face. And he doesn't recognize mine either. I can still see the skin peeling from his flesh. But that's okay. I just hope he can still look at my face and recognize me as his mother. The receptionist showed me the way to invite people into my aftergrave by using their DNA. I don't know the name of the man who was in there, but he left his matchbox in the house after he killed us. And I think I found it in our aftergrave.
If you've gotten far enough to find the key to my diary, then you're probably the person I'm writing this to. I don't know your name. I don't know why you did what you did. But I do remember that symbol. It's the only thing that I saw. And it's the only thing I won't forget.
Thank you. Thank you. To go outside of the afterlife, but
you don't understand. That guy over there, he's the reason why we're here.
And what makes you say that?
That symbol on his arm. The man who killed us had the same one. He's the one who killed us.
Well, an individual who goes by the name
William Turner
has told me that he was the fireman who was trying to save you two.
Wait. What?
So that would mean that his brother is the one who killed you. He's got a real tattoo on his arm, while this little tootsie roll just seems to have gotten a conveniently shaped scratch.
Damn.
What's going on? Is William here too? Was this poor guy trying to save us? Is his brother still here?
I forget I ever said anything.
No, you have to tell me more. Stop that.
I don't know what you're talking about, but it looks like you two have passed outside of your aftergrave portal. And that means I have to send you back to your aftergrave. Ta-ta!
Tell him that we're...
Hello, and welcome aboard on the Visitor Glide. You are currently being transported to the aftergrave of your inviter. You will arrive shortly. A welcome gift has been sent from your inviter. The teleportation of your gift will commence in approximately 3 seconds.
God, you made it. I was worried they were gonna catch up to you in the hallway. Don't you remember me? Well then, let me refresh your memory. You did the best you could, and that's more than enough. Honestly, I wish I died in that house fire. Because that would mean I would be with them right now. I died in the hospital. And that was enough for them to separate our aftergraves. And as every day goes by, it hurts even more to not be there with them. I miss them so much. This world is heavily surveilled so that the dead won't try to go outside of their aftergrave borders. Usually the only ones that have access to the security system are the ones with authority in this world. But there's this guy in this world that you've probably met. The robot. Well, he cares. He gave me this system so I could watch over my family. And ever since the day I got this, I've been staring at the screen, waiting for the day my family would find and invite the person that they have been looking for. And then, you two came along. The invitation system only accepts one person at a time. But I guess you two mess up the system by being at the same place at the wrong time. And I instantly knew what was going on when I saw the symbol he cut into your flesh. Because you're our only hope. This world is like a threshold to the afterlife. A waiting area where we need to find peace with our demise before we can cross over into the true afterlife, leaving our limbo state behind. Some do it by just letting time pass by. But in our case, time will never heal our wounds. If you avenge us, we can cross over into the true afterlife. I will be with my family again. Please, help us before it's too late. And help yourself before it's too late. Let me just show you. Your brother is on his way to leave this world through the visitor exit as we speak. The portal only opens for one visitor per invitation. If he passes through, it will close. Your brother is trying to trap you here for all eternity. He couldn't get my family to kill you, so he's trying to get rid of you by giving you something worse than death. Spending an eternity alive. I can't thank you enough. The robot, or should I say, the human. Have a look at the news article on my desk. You will not only be saving us, but you'll be saving him as well. Tell him everything you know and he will definitely take you to the visitor exit. You'll be free from his aftergrave. Ring the bell when you're ready and you'll be teleported to the reception hall. And hey, don't look down on yourself because you couldn't save us back in the fire. Because you're saving all of us.
Majesty. How can I help you today? I don't need any help. I don't need helping. But that's the helper. What doesn't make any sense? Because I'm just a rock.
Thank you. because it's still too powerful. I don't want to live here. Deep down, I feel my anxiety and feel it. But my purpose, not always in so much of a charge. It hurts to say it, but that's the truth.
Principessa, nella tua fredda stanza.